But when you're driving in Coimbatore street, do you have to avoid the moon? I'm asking, do you have to avoid the moon? No, because the moon is not on the street, isn't it? So similarly, right now are you angry? No? Then why should you avoid it? Baby, you can call me a superman.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel.
It's your boy Jessy Keegan
and your girl Fanny&jessy.
And we are Fanny&jessy. So right about now we're gonna do another reaction, but before we get into the reaction, guys, we want to thank everybody out there who've been subscribing to the channel. You're the realest MVP. We're soon gonna get to 10,000 subscribers, and I know we're gonna get there in 2 days. Yeah, and it's possible, man. And right about now we're gonna do another reaction. This one already was suggested by a lot of people too, and they suggested that we should go react to Sadhguru, how to control anger. And yeah, I mean, most of people will know how to control their anger, but maybe there's another way of controlling your anger. Probably we're gonna know in this video. And yeah, let's find out. And without any further ado, guys, let's get it.
Swamiji, can you explain what is life? How can we avoid angry?
I'm sorry, what is?
Explain what is life.
What is life?
Yeah.
Oh. And what's the second part of it?
How can you avoid angry?
How can you avoid anger? See, if you're driving in the Coimbatore streets, you have to avoid the medians which are in placed in odd places. You have to avoid bad drivers. You have to avoid drunken men crossing the street, children crossing the street, all kinds of things. But when you're driving in Coimbatore street, do you have to avoid the moon? I'm asking. Do you have to avoid the moon? No, because the moon is not on the street, isn't it? So similarly, right now are you angry? No? Then why should you avoid it? There's no need to avoid it. It is just that you think anger is an entity. Anger is not an entity. You become angry. You become angry. Anger is not sitting somewhere and you go hit it. There is no such thing. You become angry. When you become angry, is it pleasant for you or unpleasant for you? Unpleasant for you. Unpleasant for others for sure. Unpleasant for yourself also. Today, medical science proves to you, when you're angry, you're actually poisoning your system. You know, we have always known this, but today chemical tests clearly show you that you're actually poisoning your system, generating poison in the system by being angry. So, why would you want to poison yourself? It is not a conscious act. You're poisoning yourself, you're causing unpleasantness to yourself only because your mind is not taking instructions from you, isn't it? It is not taking instructions from you. If it was taking instructions from you, you would have said blissfulness, isn't it? You wouldn't say anger. But now when you want to be peaceful, it is getting angry because it is not taking instructions from you. So if your mind is not taking instructions from you, you have to pay a little more attention to it. Why is it not taking instructions from you? If you understand this, you don't have to avoid anger. Because anger is not sitting there and getting at you. You are becoming angry. You are becoming unhappy. You are becoming miserable. These things are happening to you essentially because you have not done anything to take your faculties under your control. It is happening accidentally, just by chance. If outside situations are good, you are also good. If outside situations are bad, you're also bad. That is not how human life should be. Human life should be like this. If I am good, everything around me becomes good. This should be the reality, isn't it? right now if things around me are whichever way, I will become that way. No, no. Human consciousness should create situations. Right now situations are creating human consciousness. That's not the right way to shape human life.
Such a good message. I like the ending, towards the end, when he said like, situations are creating human conscience nowadays. And it's true, like, the things that we are putting ourselves into is actually, we are not thinking for ourselves nowadays. We are kind of doing things per the situations that are out there, you get it? And it's so sad to say that anyway, but I like the way he tackled the question about anger. Why do we get hungry? For me, I'll be like, we get angry because somebody is annoying us or annoys me. You get it? But he was, no, I mean,
but then it's just not like baggage the question that avoiding. You can pick up.
Yeah, the question is how to avoid anger. But at what point do anger come to you? Do you follow it? Does it come to you? Or you create that situation in your mind? Understand? I feel it's something that has to be triggered by another subject or somebody or anything out there, you understand?
Sometimes you're upset with yourself.
Yeah.
I could have done my assignment earlier, but here I am.
Yeah. I wanted to wake up in the morning, but I woke up late, so I'm upset, so I'm hungry, you get it? So you end up, like just the way towards the end you were saying about the situation are creating, situations are creating what? Human conscience or something? Which is what we are talking about right now. If you do something wrongly, you end up feeling angry about yourself or feeling angry about just generally you get it. But now what's really bad is that you carry that anger to each and every person that you see.
Not every person that you see, rather a situation that you're putting yourself into. You're going to class, you're even upset with the lecturer for what?
Yeah, I mean, you're transferring that energy to another person.
To another environment.
To, yeah, to a very innocent environment, an innocent person, innocent, you know. And I don't know, it's just, but how can we avoid anger?
That's why I like the saying, it's not what someone does to you, it's the way you react.
Yes.
Okay, fine, I woke up late today. But then what can I do about it?
Mm-hmm.
Find ways to tackle your situation. You don't have to ruin your entire day by being upset with yourself. Just do what you have to do. If you are supposed to do something at 8, you can do it whenever you wake up.
Yeah.
If someone has wronged you, it's just up to you. Just tell yourself not to lose it. See the good, try understand them as well. Okay, weigh your options. Okay, maybe this person was right here. Okay, this, calm yourself down, understand everything. And maybe you can avoid anger. But now,
okay, as much as we want to avoid anger, there are people we call short-tempered people. They get it.
Even they can avoid anger.
They get it. That's their nature. I don't know if they have it in their DNA or whatever the situation. Yes, they can avoid, but it's there in their DNA. So what, at what level of, cause they get.
What makes like, someone short tempered? You've programmed yourself to react to situations like that.
Mm-hmm.
You've told yourself every time something goes on, I will react like this.
Mm-hmm.
You can control yourself, whatever the situation.
Control here is the major factor, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
But now, there are people out there who want to control themselves, but they end up not controlling themselves. What do you think happens in that particular period of time? Do you think that
you let yourself
they have
be.
Overpowered?
Your anger has overpowered you. Yeah. You're letting it control you. You're not thinking. That's why when you're upset, you can say all these things, very mean things.
So safe
but
to
the
say.
The minute you calm down, you're like, oh my goodness, why did I say that?
So safe to say is that everybody has the power of control. Everybody has the power is within you to control any situation out there. It's just you need to know how to just balance situations. You might be angry now, but if you calm down, yeah, that's why there are different type of practices out there. You can breathe in and out, just like when you when someone is panicking, or maybe when someone not panicking, when someone is nervous and you're told just relax, just cool down, breathe in and out and then cool down. There are many ways to practice on how to reduce anger, and also there are also spiritual ways. There's you can meditate, you can take a walk through nature just to see the birds, the animals, go out, breathe the nice fresh air or something like that. Go to people who are happy, you get it? Because if you're hungry and you go to a place...
I don't think you should rely on people. First work on it yourself.
Yeah.
Before you expose yourself to crowds.
The power is within you. You can do anything you want to do. So it's just, I think it's just something to...
It's all about the mindset.
Yeah, it's all about the mindset. And don't let... Just like the way it said it towards the end, situations are the one that are they're creating human conscience. So let not the situation or any environment make you feel okay. You can the situation can make you feel angry, but you can avoid such kind of situation. You get it? Yeah, I think I made a point there. I don't know. Anyway, guys, if you feel like you reacted to me in a better way, give us a thumbs up. And don't forget to go down our comment section and tell us exactly what you feel about our reaction. And what you feel about Sadhguru on this video right here, how to control anger. If you have better explanation on how to control anger, just let us know in the comment section below. We'll be gladly to read your comment and be able also to reply back to you. And yeah, then the most important thing, guys, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The more you keep on subscribing, the more you give us the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you a better content. And last but not the least, we're going to see you in the next video. And peace out.